Sue and I came to Malawi in 1990, looking for a place where the Word of God, the message of God, the gospel hadn't been preached yet. And so when we heard of this tribe that we're working with now, the Ao tribe, that fit both the physical poverty and the spiritual poverty.
There was mostly the unreached people groups.
They are poor, they live off the land, they're basically farmers.
So we have also these discipleship groups in the different villages. It's not us going there, but it's the leaders who meet with these people, share the word of God, pray for each other, and even encourage other people to reach out as well.
In this area, discipleship groups are off to a good start, and we are continuing to start more. As of now, we have about 20 to 30 discipleship groups. But I want these groups to be started everywhere in my area because we have so many people.
We had it in our hearts that for God's kingdom to really come, we needed to figure out some way to engage leaders. We are engaging leaders that govern about 2 million people with God's story, and they're participating in an ongoing dialogue about how God wants to transform their society, about how the kingdom of God needs to come.
First, we have to know God. Second, we have to work on growing enough food and learning how to take care of ourselves and stay healthy. Third, we need to have good behavior as a community and how we treat one another. If we do that, things will go well. That change is what I have been praying for.
We have Bible translation where we are translating the Bible into the native language.
Now we start little by little, people now starting enjoying to receiving the word of God through their mother tongue language.
It's changing the community. It's changing even the leadership.
So we cannot keep up with all the requests, whether it's requests for Bible materials, requests for people to come and help start groups, requests for biblically based development.
We want to ask the people in America who are helping us, whether financially or in other kinds of support, to continue. The time will come when we have the capacity to stand on our own and do what needs to be done ourselves. That will be in the future. But for now, we ask you to please continue your support.